With 3 decades of experience of printing and embroidery, Acorn Printing have a client base including many household names and have even supplied t-shirts for the President of the United States. As the official teamwear supplier for BOSRA, you can order from our current range at t-shirtuk.com. Hello everybody, welcome back to BOSRA Race Roundup. We're here today for the latest installment of the 2016 BOSRA MSA Skip Barber Championship. Round 9 today comes from Suzuka International Grand Prix Circuit and late afternoon race with clear skies as well. After last week's race at Summit Point Raceway, it is Sober Round who leads the driver standings ahead of Antonades with just 15 points separating them. Simon Unhill currently sits third in the championship. So will this race today see Sober Round extend that lead? As you can see, he's taken pole ahead of Antonades once again. Ben Hackerson starts in third ahead of the Baird brothers Tony and then Barry. Neil Bamber sits sixth ahead of Van Delden and Simon Underhill in eighth. Martin Gwenicke, ninth for Motorsport Auctions, ahead of Alan McCain and Phil Gregory. Russell Barnes starts 12th ahead of Ian Robson and Simon Jackson. David Rowan for Bentley Boys Racing, a third of the three cars there, is just ahead of Jan Mollesver in 16th. It's also worth noting that today marks the 6th pole position for Sober Round in this event. Don't forget we're only in round 9, so fantastic achievement for him. Further down in the qualifying, it was Honey Smith in 17th, then Jonathan Beresford and newcomer John Woolridge in 19th. Ricky Green rounds out in 20th. So it's not a full grid by any stretch of the imagination. This week's qualifying lap, we're going on board with 3rd place Ben Hackerson. So he set a 2 minute 24.137. If you're looking to upgrade your racing experience, then head over to Bowden Solutions. They offer the first and only bolt-on load cell brake mod for Thrustmaster pedals, and the TX-G27 adapter allows you to use your Logitech pedals with a Thrustmaster wheel. See the link below for more information. So this is the view on board with Ben Hackerson. He had completed his out lap and this was the first lap of the qualifying session that was timed. You can see just in front of him his teammate Antonades for XL Designs. Coming down now towards the first couple of turns, hard on the brakes coming into here, into the double apex right-hander, turns 1 and 2. It then leads on into the S-curves. This is turns 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So through here it is first a left, then a right, then another left and right. Then it sweeps up along the Dunlop curve. So as you can see, Ben is catching his teammate just in front using the draft to the best of his ability. Now coming through into the final part of here, this is going through turn 6 and into turn number 7 now. So the next left-hander then sweeps us down through Dunlop curve and into Degner curve, which is turns 8 and 9. We're going to follow Ben up here over the top of the hill. Ben once again try to tuck in and use that draft as we come down here. Quite a difficult corner to get right, the first part of this in Degner curve number 8. So over the rumble strip and going wide out here. It's then hard on the brake as it tightens up into turn number 9. We now go under the bridge as well, which we will come across as we go through turn 15 in a minute or so. Now we're making our way up towards the hairpin, turns 10 and 11. This is probably one of the slowest corners in all of iRacing, so it seems to carry on forever. Use as much of the track once again as you can. We are now coming down through turns 12 and 13, up towards Spoon Curve. So this flows quite nicely, get some speed up here. Plenty of opportunity to pass if you've come out the hairpin and got a good start out of there. So once again, hugging the rumble strips and staying out wide into turn number 13. You can see off in the distance there's been an accident. Hopefully that won't bung up the track too much, so everyone keeping out the way. See Ben now right hot on the heels of his teammate. This is where on the back straight you want to be, towing as much as you can. Get the draft here up through the hill, over the bridge, and then as we come down towards turns 15 and 16 and into the final few corners. So you see Antonades not putting up too much resistance in qualifying, letting his teammate pass. Now into the fast left hander. This is turn 15 on top of the bridge. Now we're making our way down towards the casino triangle, which is turns 16, 17, and then in towards turn 18. So hard on the brakes here. It is a right-left flick, two or three different options of track set up there. So through the final few corners now comes Ben, through final turn number 18, past the pit entrance on the right-hand side, and through onto the main straight to complete the lap. Hackerson's time was a 2 minute 24.137 despite what it shows you on your screen. It's 0.786 behind the leader, so let's head to the race. The Synology DS216 Play is a 2-bay NAS featuring 4K video transcoding and powerful processing capabilities. Complement yours with Seagate NAS hard drives for the perfect high capacity storage solution. See the video description for more details. We'll be right back. Motorsport Auctions are the global marketplace to buy and sell used racing rally cars, parts, transporters and associated equipment. With competitive pricing on all types of membership, list your items now at motorsportauctions.com. To the race results then, and what a fantastic finish it was. It was Antonades taking the win just ahead of Ben Hackerson in second. Sobran finished third, and then it's Tony Bird and Van Delden in fifth, Martin Gwanicki, Neil Bamber and Simon Underhill. McCain finished ninth, ahead of Phil Gregory and Simon Jackson in 11th, with Ricky Green in 12th and Russell Barnes 13th. David Rowan for Bentley Boys in 14th, ahead of his teammate Ian Robson, Daniel Honeysmith in 16th for Acorn Printing. It was a bad week for the second of the Bird brothers, finished in 17th, ahead of John Woolridge and Jan Malesovic in 19th, Jonathan Beresford three laps down to Seagate and Snow in 20th. The driver standings, there's only 9 points separating the top two, with Simon Underhill in 3rd. Bamber and Jackson are tied on 114 points, with Van Delden and Ben Hackerson close behind. Then it's down to Phil Gregory in 8th and Martin Gwenicke in 9th. Tony Bird sits 10th, ahead of Darren Ford and Barry Bird. Chris Buttrell's 13th, Owen McCain 14th, with David Waldock in 15th and Matt Tillet in 16th for Seagate and Synology. The second half of the driver standings looks like this, with Russell Barnes followed by Piercy Green and Melisba, Ian Robson's 21st ahead of his teammate David Rowland, Ian Thorne's 23rd with Ryan Walker and Martin Brandon next, Scott Malcolm 26th. Further down, John Woolridge jumped into the top 32 standings on 3 points. Changes in the team standings this week, but XL Design still lead the way by 70 points, Seagate and Snorgy jump back to second ahead of Team Clockwork, Bowden Solutions move up one into fourth, and then demotes Bentley Boys Racing to fifth, with Motorsport Auctions, Tech Speed Racing and Acorn Printing remaining where they are. Next week we're off to Twin Ring Motegi, that marks the halfway point within the event, so we hope you'll join us for that. As usual, if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, and if you didn't, leave us a comment below to let us know why. So thank you ever so much for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.